online class day 4. In today's class, we are going to see workbook lesson number 11, force, work and energy. So what lesson we are going to see today? We are going to see workbook lesson number 11, force, work and energy. Lesson number 1, going to school, and workbook lesson number 11, force, work, energy are combined lessons. So in our previous class, we learned about lesson number 1, going to school. So from today's class, we'll be learning about workbook lesson number 11, force, work and energy.
In today's class, we are going to learn topic force, work, simple machines. In simple machines, we are going to learn inclined plane, wedges and screw. Yes, shall we start the class?
So in today's class, we are going to learn about force. So look at these pictures. So in this picture, you can see some people are pulling something and while other people are pushing something. So what is this pushing and pulling? This pushing and pulling are called force. An object is said to move only when we apply force. Without applying force, will the object move? No. For example, if I want to close the door. So if I want to close the door, without applying the force, will the door close automatically? No, right? So an object will move only when we apply force. So what is force? A force can be a push or a pull. So only by these two ways, I can apply the force. So what is force? A force is a push or a pull. What is force? A force can be a push or a pull. So we all know that living things can move from one place to another place by themselves. For example, if I want to move from this place to that place, I can move by myself. I don't want anyone's help to make me move from this place to another place. But will the non-living things move on their own? No, right? So we need to apply force on the non-living things to make them move from one place to another. So now let us see with a small example. I have a pen in my hand. If I want to write something, what should I do first? First, I should remove this pen cap. So without applying force, can I remove this pen cap? Can I? No, right? So an object moves only when the force is applied. So this object will be removed only when I apply force to it, right? So what force? The force can be in two forms. What are they? One is push or a pull. So either by applying a push or a pull, I have to remove this pen cap. So what force I can apply to this pen to make this cap remove? So now I'm going to apply the force called pull. So what force I'm going to apply here? Pull. Pull na nadu irukkirathu. So I'm going to apply the force called pull and I'm removing this pen cap. So now I don't want to write anything. I want to close this pen cap. So by applying the force called push. Push na nadu. Kalradu. So I'm applying this force called push and I'm closing this pen cap. So a force can be a push or a pull. An object will move only when the force is applied to it. Without applying the force, can I open this pen cap? No, right? So an object will move only when the force is applied to it. What is force? A push or a pull acting on an object. A push or a pull acting on an object. Will you all repeat with me? What is force? A push or a pull acting on an object is called force. By applying force, I can do four things. What are they? By applying force, I can make an object move. So what can I do? I can make an object move. By applying force, I can stop the moving object. By applying force, I can stop a moving object. By applying force, I can change the direction of an object. By applying force, I can change the shape of an object. So what are the four things? I can make an object move. I can stop the movement of an object. I can change the direction of an object. I can change the shape of an object. How can I make an object move by applying force? Look at this picture. In this picture, you can see a boy is trying to push that ball.
So, he wants to move that ball.
So, he is going to apply the force called push. So, what is push? Thalradu, right? So, he is applying the force called push and he is trying to move the ball away from himself. So, before that ball was static in that place. What is static? It is not moving anywhere. So, by applying the force, after when he applied the force called push,
the ball moved from that place.
So, by applying the force, I can make an object move from that place. So, by applying force, I can make an object move. So, by applying force, I can stop a moving object. How can I stop a moving object? Let's see. So, I have a ball. This ball is rolling, okay? So, I don't want this ball to roll further. I want to stop its movement. How can I stop? By applying the force. Yes, I can stop it. By applying the force called pull. What is pull? Irukkirathu. So, by applying the force called pull, I am stopping the movement of an object. So, when I pull the object, I am bringing the object closer to myself. So, when I apply the force called pull, I can stop the movement of an object. How can I change the direction of an object by applying force? So, let us take a example, cricket game. Okay, so you all know cricket, right? So, let us take that example. So, a ball is coming to a batsman, okay? So, a ball is coming to him. He wants to make that ball hit six. So, what he is doing, he is going to apply the force on the bat. So, he is trying to apply the force on the bat and he is trying to change the direction of that ball. So, the ball is coming straight to him. So, when he apply the force through the bat, when he try to apply the force, the direction of the ball changes and it reaches the six. So, by applying the force, we can change the direction of an object, even in the football game. So, when he wants to reach the goal, when he wants to kick the ball towards the goal, so what he will do? So, when he will kick the ball towards the goal side, right? So, he will change the direction of the object by applying force. So, by applying the force, I can change the direction of an object. How can I change the shape of an object by applying force? So, let us see with an example. Imagine I have a clay in my hand. So, what is clay? You all know, right? So, imagine I have a clay in my hand. So, when I apply the force on it, the shape of that clay changes. So, by applying the force, I can change the shape of an object. Let us see with another example. So, I have a rubber ball in my hand. So, what shape is it in? It is in spherical in shape, right? So, when I apply the force, it changes its shape. So, by applying the force, I can change the shape of an object. So, force is applied to make an object move, to stop a moving object, to change the direction of an object, to change the shape of an object.
So, only for these four reasons, we are applying force. So, what are the four reasons?
To make an object move, to stop a moving object, to change the direction of an object, and to change the shape of an object. So, what is force? A push or a pull acting on an object. So, what is force? A push or a pull acting on an object. So, non-living, we all know that non-living thing don't move from one place to another. So, object will move only when we apply force on it. So, force is, what is force? A force can be a push or a pull. So, why I'm applying force?
Force is applied for four reasons.
To make an object move, to stop the moving object, to change the direction of an object, to change the shape of an object. So, what is force? A push or a pull acting on an object. A push or a pull acting on an object. An object moves only when force is applied to it. Without applying force, we cannot make an object move. So, by applying the force, I can make the object move, I can stop the moving object, I can change the direction of the object, I can change the shape of an object.
So, we learned about what is force and why we are applying force. So, now we are going to learn types of forces. There are 6 types of forces. They are
muscular force, gravitational force, magnetic force, frictional force, elastic force and mechanical force. What are they? Muscular force, gravitational force, magnetic force, frictional force, elastic force and mechanical force. So the first force that we are going to learn is muscular force. So what is muscular force? When we use our muscle strength to lift heavy things is called muscular force. When we use our muscle strength to lift heavy things is known as muscular force. For example, can you see stone in front of me? Yes. So if I want to lift this heavy stone, I should use my muscular force, right? Only then I can lift this heavy stone. So that is known as muscular force. So if I want to lift this heavy stone, I should apply my muscular force. So that is known as muscular force. So what is muscular force? When I use my muscle strength to lift heavy things is known as muscular force. The example of muscular force is riding a bicycle. So will the bicycle will move directly without applying force? No, right? So you have to sit on the cycle and you have to pedal the wheel. So when you are pedaling the wheel, so you are applying your muscle strength from your leg. So you are giving all your muscle strength to the wheel. So you are pedaling the wheel. So by applying the force, muscular force, you are pedaling the cycle and you are making the cycle to move. So what is muscular force? You are giving all your muscle strength to make an object move. That is called muscular force. Next, what we are going to see is gravitational force. What is gravitational force? Whenever we throw any object up, again it comes back to us. So it goes up for some time, again it comes back. That is called gravitational force. The force between the earth and the object. Whatever object is thrown up, again it falls back. The earth will pull the object towards itself. That is called gravitational force. For example, I have a ball in my hand. So I am going to throw this ball up. Will this ball go up? No, right? It comes back. Let us see. Okay. So I am throwing this ball. So again it falls back to me. So this is called gravitational force. The object goes up. It goes up for some time. Again it falls back to the earth itself. Why it is falling back to the earth itself again? Because there is a force called gravity between the earth and the object. So whatever object is thrown up,
again the earth will pull back.
So that is called gravity or gravitational force. The earth will pull the object towards itself. Why it is pulling the object towards itself? Because the force called gravity. Imagine that there is no gravity in the earth. What happens? For example, I have a ball. If there is no gravity, what happens to this ball? This ball will float. It will not come back to the earth. It will just float in the air. So gravity
will pull the object
itself. Where you can see the zero gravity? Only in the space. So only in the space there is zero gravity. Earth has gravity. Because of gravity, it pulls back the object towards itself. So what is gravitational force? The force by which earth pulls all the objects towards it is called gravitational force. The force by which earth pulls all the objects towards it is called gravitational force, right? Yes. For example, you would have seen many trees, right? Yes. So in front of me you can see an apple tree, right? Yes. So whenever the fruits get ripened, what happened to it, children? So the fruits falls down, right? Why it is falling down? Because of gravitational force. So why the fruits are falling down? Because of gravitational force. So the gravity which is there in the earth will pull the object towards it is called gravitational force.
So whenever this fruit gets ripened, it falls down to the earth. It will not go to the sky. Why? Because of gravity. So the gravity which is there in the earth will pull the object towards it. It's called gravitational force. Okay. So what is gravitational force? The earth pulls the objects towards it is called gravitational force. So whenever the fruits get ripened, it just falls down because of gravity which is there in the earth.
So the gravity which is there in the earth will pull the object towards it is called gravitational force. Did you know Sir Isaac Newton's apple tree still stands today, more than 350 years after it helped him discover gravity?
So the next force that we are going to learn is magnetic force. The force applied by the magnet is called magnetic force. The force applied by the magnet is called magnetic force.
The magnet will attract the object made of iron.
So whatever object is made of iron will be attracted by magnet. So that is known as magnetic force. The force applied by the magnet is called magnetic force.
Take a few iron nails or pins and keep them on a piece of paper. Bring a magnet near them. What do you observe? The nails or pins move towards the magnet and get stuck to it. The force by which the nails are attracted towards the magnet is called magnetic force.
So the next force that we are going to learn is mechanical force. What force? Mechanical force. The force used by the machine to lift heavy object is known as mechanical force. So whenever we want to lift heavy things, what we will use? We will use our muscle force, right? Like that. Machines will use its force called mechanical force to lift the heavy object. So the force used by the machine to lift heavy object is known as mechanical force. For example, crane. You would have seen the crane lifting the heavy objects, right? So that is known as mechanical force. The force used by the machines to lift heavy objects is known as mechanical force. So what is mechanical force? The force used by the machine to lift heavy objects is known as mechanical force. So you would have seen crane lifting heavy objects, right? So that is known as mechanical force. The crane is using mechanical force to lift the heavy object. So the force used by the machines to lift heavy objects is known as mechanical force. So next force is elastic force. So what is the next force? Elastic force. When we stretch any object is known as elastic force. For example, rubber band. So whenever we stretch the rubber band, it is stretching, right? So that is known as elastic force. When we stretch any object, that is known as elastic force. So when we stretch any object, that is known as what? Elastic force.
Next, what we are going to see is frictional force. What force? Frictional force. The force between the two objects when they are in contact, when the two objects touch or rub each other, the friction is produced. So this is called frictional force. This force, the force which helps stop or slows down the movement of an object. So with the help of frictional force, I can stop or I can slow down the movement of an object. So what is frictional force?
When two objects touch or rub each other, friction is produced.
So I can stop or I can slow down the movement of an object using this frictional force. So I told you, right, this frictional force stops the moving object. How it is stopping the moving object? Imagine that we are riding a cycle. So if you want to stop the cycle, what we will do? We will apply the brake, right? So when we apply the brake, what happens? The brake and the tire touch each other. So when the two objects touch or rub each other, friction is produced. So what are the two objects here? Tire is one object and brake shoe is another object. So when these two objects touch or rub each other, friction is produced. So due to the friction, the object stops. So friction helps the object to stop. Friction help us to walk without falling or slipping down. You can ask me, right, miss, what? Friction is helping us to walk? Yes, friction is helping us to walk without falling down. For example, I told you, right, when the two objects touch or rub each other, friction is produced. So imagine this is the ground, okay? So ground is one object and our foot is one object. When these two objects touch or rub each other, friction is produced. So when the friction is produced, we can walk properly without falling down. So when there is less friction, we are falling down. When the friction will become less, for example, the ground is there. On top of the ground, there is a banana peel. If you are going to keep a leg on the banana peel, what happens? We are not touching the ground directly, right? In between the ground and the foot, there is one more object called banana peel. So when we touch that banana peel, what happens? We are falling down. Why we are falling down? Because of less friction. In lesson number 1, going to school, we saw, right, in Northern Hills, the people, children in Northern Hills, when they are going to school, they will hold one another when they are walking. Why they are holding one another? Because they are walking in the snow path. So when they are walking in the snow path, what happens? The friction will be very, very less. When there is less friction, what happens? They may fall down. So to prevent them from falling, they are holding one another.
So now we are going to learn about work. So what is work, children? So whenever we do any physical or mental work, we call it as work, right? So whenever we think of something, whenever we write something, then we call it as work, right? But in science, the meaning of this word work is different. For example, when you think something or when you're watching TV, if your mother asks you something, what you will say? I'm watching TV, I'm doing some work, please don't disturb me, right? But actually, according to science, that is not work at all. So according to science, the work is said to be done only when the objects move from one place to another due to the force acting on it. So according to science, the work is said to be done only when the object move from that place to another due to the force acting on it.
Look at the pictures given. In the first picture, Rogan is pushing a big box. He is able to move the box a short distance. In this case, work is said to be done. Look at the second picture. Karan is pushing a wall. He won't be able to move the wall no matter how hard he pushes. In this case, no work is done.
So in science, the work is said to be done only when the object moves from one place to another due to the force acting on it. So according to science, the work is said to be done only when the object moves from one place to another due to the force acting on it. So what is work done according to science? The object must be moved from that place. It must be displaced from that place due to the force acting on it. So what is the meaning of displaced? Displaced means object moved from that place, okay? The distance covered by the object. So according to science, the work is said to be done only when the object moves from that place to another due to the force acting on it. In our daily life, we do so many work, children, right? Yes. Is it possible to do all the work only with our hands? Is it possible? No, right? For example, if I want to cut some vegetables, is it possible to cut the vegetables evenly with my hands? Is it possible? No, right. I need a knife, right? Yes. And if I want to keep my nails clean, what should I do? I should use my nail cutter to cut it shapely and evenly, right? Yes. So I need a nail cutter. So these tools are called simple tools, simple machines. So it is not possible for us to do all our works with our hands. So we use simple machines to make our work easier. So what is simple machine? Simple machines are the tools which make our work easier and in less period of time. For example, knife, nail cutter, screw, all these are simple machine. So it is very simple, right? It is not very big machinery. It is very just simple tools. So with help of that tools, I can make my work easily as well as in lesser period of time, right? So what are simple machines? The tools which make our work easier are called simple machines. So what are simple machines? The tools which make our work easier and in less period of time are called simple machines. The tools which make our work easier and in lesser period of time are called simple machines. Yes. And there are six simple machines. There are six simple machines. They are
inclined plane, wedge, screw, lever, wheel and axle, pulley. Inclined plane, wedge, screw, lever, wheel and axle, pulley.
In today's class, we are going to see only three simple machines. So, the first simple machine that we are going to learn is inclined plane. Yes, can you see an inclined plane here? Yes. So, what is an inclined plane? Inclined plane is nothing but it's a slope, a ramp. Palaga solvanga, that is inclined plane. Okay, it is a simple tool, but that make our work very easier. What it can do, children? Yes. So the simple tool, no, the simple machine, inclined plane, is used to move heavy things from one surface to another surface. For example, this inclined plane is used to move an object from lower surface to higher surface. Yes. So with the help of this inclined plane, I can move my object. So it is used to move object from one level to another, from lower surface to higher surface. So inclined plane is nothing but a slope, a ramp. Palaga solvangala. So that is inclined plane. So with the help of this simple tool, I can easily lift my heavy object from lower surface to higher surface.
If Dhakkan here wants to lift and place this barrel on a ledge, it is a bit difficult. With the help of an inclined plane, Dhakkan can now roll the same mass up a sloping surface with much less effort.
So with the help of this inclined plane, I can easily move the object. Yes. So next simple machine that we are going to learn is wedges. Yes. So two inclined planes meet at one end and form a sharp edge, V shape. Okay. For example, knife. In the knife, you can see two slopes, right? So these two slopes meet at one end. That end form sharp edge, right? In that edge, you can see it is very sharp, right? Yes. So that is known as wedge. Yes. Can you see a woodcutter? Yes. What is having in his hand? Yes. Axe. So with the help of axe, he can cut things, right? Yes. So wedges are used to cut things. So knife, axe, all these are what? Examples of wedges. So these are simple tools, but which make our work very easier. So what is wedge? Two inclined plane meet at one end and form a sharp edge. Okay. And wedge is used for splitting or cutting things. Okay. So wedge is used for what? Cutting things. Yes. So axe, knife, all these are wedges. Yes. So next simple machine that we are going to learn is what? Screw. Yes. So what is the simple machine that we are going to learn now? Yes, screw. A nail with grooves in it is called screw. So what is nail, children? Ani, right? So can you see this? So this is a screw, right? So a nail with grooves in it. Can you see a ring here? Yes, can you see this rings? That is known as grooves, okay? A nail with grooves in it is called screw. So we use this screw in our daily life, right? To fix up something or to hold something, we need this screw. We can easily fix the screw with the help of screwdriver. So this is what? Screwdriver. So if you want to fix up the screw with the help of screwdriver, we can easily fix it up. So a nail with grooves in it is called screw. A nail with grooves in it is called screw. So we use screw in our daily life to hold or to fix up many things. So in today's class, we learned about force and we also learned about work, right?
What is force? First, what we saw? what is force? What is force? Push or a pull. So what is force? A push or a pull acting on an object is called force. So what is force? Repeat with me. A push or a pull acting on an object is called force. So what is force? A push or a pull acting on an object is called force. Why we are applying force? We are applying force for four reasons. What are they? To make an object move. To make an object move. To stop the moving object. To stop the moving object. To change the direction of an object. To change the direction of an object. To change the shape of an object. To change the shape of an object. So only for four reasons we are applying force. So what is force? A push or a pull acting on an object. So we are applying force to make the object move, to stop the moving object, to change the direction of an object, to change the shape of an object. Next, we saw about types of force. There are six types of force. What are they? First one is muscular force, gravitational force. Third one is magnetic force. Fourth one is frictional force. Fifth one is elastic force. And sixth one is mechanical force. So what is muscular force? When we use a muscle strength to lift heavy things are called muscular force. When we use a muscle strength to lift heavy things are called muscular forces. Next, what we are going to see is gravitational force. What is gravitational force? The force between the earth and the object. The force between the earth and the object.
The earth will pull the
object towards itself is called gravity or gravitational force. So what is the next force? So we saw about magnetic force. The force between the magnet and the iron object.
So the magnet will attract the object made of iron.
So the force between the magnet and the iron object, it is called magnetic force. Okay. So next we saw about frictional force. When two objects touch or rub each other, friction is produced. That is called frictional force. When two objects touch or rub each other, friction is produced. That is called frictional force. Frictional help us to walk without falling down. I told you there are two friction. What are they? Less friction and more friction. When the friction will be less, in smooth surface, the friction will be less. When the friction will be high, in rough surface, the friction will be high. Next, we saw about elastic force. What force? Elastic force. The force which is used to stretch the object is called elastic force. The force used to stretch the object is called elastic force. Now, what is the last force? Mechanical force. What is the last force? Mechanical force. The force used by the machine to lift heavy things are called mechanical force. The force used by machine. Okay, the force used by the machine to lift heavy things are called mechanical force. So, what is work? According to science, the work is said to be done only when the object moves from one place to another due to the force acting on it. And is that possible to do all the work with the ants, children? No, right? So we need some simple tools to make our work easier. So what are they? They are called simple machines. So what are simple machines? The tools which make our work easier and as well as in less period of time are called simple machines, right? Yes. And there are six simple machines.
In today's class, we learned three simple machines. So what are they? Inclined plane, wedge and screw. So what is an inclined plane? So a slope that is used to lift heavy things from lower surface to higher surface. And what is a wedge? A wedge is used to cut things. So wedge is used to cut things, right? And what is a screw? A nail with grooves in it is called screw, right? A nail with grooves in it is called screw. So in your next class, you will learn about the remaining simple machines.